إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى وقال ربكم ادعوني أستجب لكم. الله سبحانه وتعالى, and your Lord says, call upon me, I will respond to you. وقال ربكم ادعوني, ask me, invoke me, I will answer you. This is a promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is not to try to do. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you a promise, He will fulfill you His promise, no doubt. Inshallah, in this khutbah will come through some of the incidents from the prophets alayhi salatu wasalam to prove this principle, this foundation in the Quran, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answers you when you ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah told the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the prophets and the stories of the prophets, وَكُلَّمْ نَقُصُّ عَلَيْكَ مِنْ أَنْبَاءِ الرُّسُلِ مَا نُثَبِّتُ بِهِ فُؤَادَكَ وَجَاءَكَ فِي هَذِهِ الْحَقُّ وَمَوْعِظَةٌ وَذِكْرَى لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala, and each story, this is in Surah Hud. At the end of Surah Hud, Allah mentioned Surah Hud, the story of Nuh, the story of Hud, story of Saleh, Ibrahim, alayhim salatu wassalam. And at the end of the Surah, He said subhanahu wa ta'ala, and each story we relate to you from the news of the messengers is that by which we make firm your heart. So it is very important to know the stories of the prophets alayhim salatu wassalam. Allah mentioned the story of Ibrahim and how did he struggle with his people, especially his father, subhanallah. At the end they decided to kill Ibrahim. How? We should burn Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam. So all the community there, all of them against Ibrahim, were against Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam. قَالُوا حَرِّقُوهُ وَانْصُرُوا آلِهَتَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ فَاعِلِينَ. They said, burn Ibrahim, burn him and support your gods if you are acting, if you are to act. Imagine Ibrahim, the young man, alone. His father and all the relatives, all the people. all of his tribes and the others against him. They decided to kill him by burning him. What can he do? He was trusting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, Hasbi Allah wa ni'mal wakil. He said, Hasbi Allah wa ni'mal wakil. Allah alone is sufficient for us. Allah alone is sufficient for me. Wa ni'mal wakil. He is the best protector, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Immediately Allah said, قلنا يا نار كوني بردا وسلاما على إبراهيم. Allah gave an order, immediate order to the nar, to the fire. Allah said, O fire, be coolness and safety upon Ibrahim. This is the rule. وقال ربكم ادعوني استجب لك. Invoke me, ask me. Ibrahim asked Allah. You are the best protector, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah answered him. The fire burns everything. But for Ibrahim, coolness and safety. Everyone, وَأَرَادُوا بِهِ كَيْدًا. Allah told us that all of them, وَأَرَادُوا بِهِ كَيْدًا فَجَعَلْنَاهُمُ الْأَخْسَرِينَ. And they intended for him harm. But we made them the greatest losers. وَعْلَمْ أَنَّ الْأُمَّةَ لَوْ اجْتَمَعَتْ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَنْفَعُوكَ بِشَيْءٍ لَنْ يَنْفَعُوكَ إِلَّا بِشَيْءٍ قَدْ كَتَبَهُ اللَّهُ لَكَ وَلَوْ اجْتَمَعَتْ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَضُرُّوكَ بِشَيْءٍ لَنْ يَضُرُّوكَ إِلَّا بِشَيْءٍ قَدْ كَتَبَهُ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكَ. This is the advice from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم to his cousin Ibn Abbas. Radiallahu ta'ala an. He said, if all the people agreed upon harming you and Allah doesn't want, this will not happen. All of them agreed to burn Ibrahim and this did not happen. When he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the protection. The first messenger, Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, he was not alone but with very few believers. Maybe 20, 30, 40. But Allah told us few. وَمَا آمَنَ مَعَهُ إِلَّا قَلِيلٌ. Only few people followed Nuh عليه الصلاة والسلام. وَنُوحًا إِذْ نَادَى مِنْ قَبْلِ فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ. الله أكبر. In Surah Al-Anbiya, and mention Nuh. When he called to Allah before that time, so we responded to him and saved him. وَنَصَرْنَاهُ مِنَ الْقَوْمِ الَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا. And we saved him from the people who denied our signs. He came to a point, to a time Allah told him that no more people will accept Islam. The door of Hidayah closed at that time. 950 years. Was calling his people in different ways, in all the ways. They did not accept. So Allah told him, no one will accept Islam. Oh Nuh, finish. Then he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أَنِّي مَغْلُوبٌ فَانْتَصِرْ. Oh Allah, I am overcome. I am done. So save me, O Allah. فَفَتَحْنَا أَبْوَابَ السَّمَاءِ بِمَاءٍ مُنْهَمِرٍ وَفَجَّرْنَا الْأَرْضَ عُيُونًا فَالْتَقَى الْمَاءُ عَلَىٰ أَمْرٍ قَدْ قُدِرٍ وَحَمَلْنَاهُ عَلَىٰ ذَاتِ أَلْوَاحٍ وَدُسُرٍ. Allah opened the doors of the heaven to pour the water. And from down, there was a flood, killed everyone. Non-Muslims at that time. When Nuh asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the help. Ayyub alayhi salatu wasalam was sick for 18 years.
For 18 years, he was sick.
Everyone ran away from him, except his wife and maybe two friends. He lost his children. He lost everything in the dunya. But he did not lose his iman. The Prophet ﷺ said that the Prophet Ayyub was sick for 18 years. Everyone ran away from him. Then Ayyub said, وَأَيُّوبَ إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ أَنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الضُّرُّ وَأَنْتَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. And mention Ayyub, when he called to his Lord, indeed adversity has touched me. He was very polite in his dua, عليه الصلاة والسلام. And you are the most merciful of the merciful, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah answered him, فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ فَكَشَفْنَا مَا بِهِ مِنْ ضُرٍّ وَآتَيْنَاهُ أَهْلَهُ وَمِثْلَهُمْ مَعَهُمْ. So we responded to him and removed what afflicted him of adversity, and we gave him his family and the like thereof with them as mercy from us and a reminder for the worshippers of Allah. So this is not only for Ayyub. It is not only for Nuh. It is not only for Ibrahim. It is for all the believers. When you ask Allah, Allah will answer you. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wadhannun. Yunus, alayhi salatu wassalam. Another name, Wadhannun, Dhannun. The one, the friend of the whale. He was inside the stomach of the whale. Wadhannun, dhahaba mughadiban, fadhanna an lan naqdira alayhi, fanada. فنادى في الظلمات أن لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. يونس عليه الصلاة والسلام went out of his country without the permission of Allah. Why? Because the people did not accept Islam. He was angry because they did not accept Islam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested him. How? He was inside the stomach of the whale. They throw him inside the sea. Then the whale came. And he took Yunus. Allah says, فَنَادَى فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ. The darknesses. They say, the scholars, three darknesses. The darkness of the night. The darkness of the sea. The darkness of the stomach of the whale. No one can see Yunus except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In this darkness and this distress, he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, La ilaha illa anta subhanak, inni kuntu min al-zalimin. Do you remember this dua when you are in distress? Or only you remember your friends and your tribe, your brothers and sisters? Did you say this dua when you are in a big trouble? La ilaha illa anta subhanak, inni kuntu min al-zalimin. This is for you also, not only for Yunus. Then he said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, fastajabna lah. If you notice all of them, Allah says after the dua, fastajabna lah. It means immediately Allah answered them. Fastajabna lah. وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْغَمِّ وَكَذَلِكَ نُنْجِي الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. So we responded to him and saved him from the distress, and thus do we save the believers. So it was for Yunus and also for us. Zakaria had no children. He was old, and also his wife. So they came to an age, they lost the hope to get children, but he did not lose the hope from Allah. And he asked Allah, وَزَكَرِيَّ إِذْ نَادَ رَبَّهُ رَبِّ لَا تَذَرْنِي فَرْدًا وَأَنْتَ خَيْرُ الْوَارِثِينَ Oh Allah, don't let me alone. It means without children. وَأَنْتَ خَيْرُ الْوَارِثِينَ While you are the best of inheritors. If I have children, my children will inherit me. But you are the best inheritor, subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ The same way, the same principle. Fa, immediately. فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ وَوَهَبْنَا لَهُ يَحْيَى وَأَصْلَحْنَا لَهُ زَوْجَهُ So we responded to him and we gave to him Yahya and perfected for him his wife. Then after these incidents with Ibrahim and Nuh, Lut, Yunus, Zakaria, Allah said, إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ وَيَدْعُونَنَا رَغَبًا وَرَهَبًا وَكَانُوا لَنَا خَاشِعِينَ There is a condition. If you like to get the answer from Allah, follow this condition. What is the condition? Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala about them, the prophets alayhim salatu wasalam. Indeed, they used to hasten to good deeds and supplicate us in hope and fear, and they were to us humbly submissive. So if you like to get the answer from Allah, follow the way of these prophets. Worship Allah alone, obey Allah, invoke Allah, you will see the answer. أقول قولي هذا استغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده وعلى آله وأصحابه وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله ما بعد Every single Muslim has his own distress, his own needs, his own calamities. The question, did you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So there are some ways to invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us some of the rules, some of the manners to invoke Allah. Number one, al-ikhlas. Sincerity, you have to be sincere. Ask Allah alone, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't ask anyone other than Allah. All of the prophets asked Allah. Oh Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So sincerity is very important to get the answer from Allah. Number two, use the names of Allah. Oh Allah, Ar-Rahman, Al-Malik, Al-Quddus, Al-Shafi, Al-Hafid, Al-Aleem. Use the names of Allah in your dua. You are sick, use the name Al-Shafi, the curer. You are poor, use the name Al-Wahhab, the bestower. You need to learn, ask Allah by His name, Al-Aleem, the knowledgeable subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are confused, ask Allah Al-Hikmah, the wisdom, by His name, Al-Hakim, the wise, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So use the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your dua. Number three, repeat the dua. Don't say, I was asking Allah for 2-3 days and I did not see the answer. The sunnah is to ask Allah the first time, the second, the third. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because you are worshipping Allah. When you ask Allah, if you say, Oh Allah, forgive me my sins. Oh Allah, cure my son, my wife, my mother. This is a kind of worship. Allah will give you reward just by asking Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm asking Allah for 10 years. Until now, I don't have any children. Don't give up. Allah wants you to ask Him again and again. The righteous deeds, this is very important. You have to follow the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to obey Allah if you want Allah to answer your dua. Also try to make dua specifically in the times chosen by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. For example, in the sujood, or at the last part of the night before Fajr in 1 hour, for example. Wake up 2 a.m., 1 a.m., 3:30 before the Fajr. Make wudu, pray to rak'ah and ask Allah. Ask Allah between the adhan and the iqamah when you are in the masjid. Ask Allah before the salam at the end of the salah. You have to know what are these times. For example, today is Jum'ah. The Prophet ﷺ said, you have a dua will be answered at the end of the day. Jum'ah means before Maghrib. So try to find these times to make the dua. You can't ask Allah any time, but these specific times, the dua is more powerful. And at the end, don't say, I ask Allah, and I did not see the answer, I will stop. This is the way of the kuffar, not the way of the Muslim. The Muslim should not lose the hope. Don't say, I was asking Allah, and I did not see the answer. Then there is no use of my dua. There is a use of your dua, and you will get the answer in a different ways, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam mentioned. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to answer our dua. Allahumma aghfir lil mu'minin wal mu'minat wal muslimin wal muslimat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat innaka sami'un قريب مجيب الدعوات يا رب العالمين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار اللهم اجعل هذا البلد آمنا مطمئنا وسائر بلاد المسلمين اللهم احفظ إخواننا المسلمين في كل مكان في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها يا رب العالمين اللهم اشف مرضانا اللهم اشف مرضانا اللهم اشف مرضانا وعاف مبتلانا واجمعنا على طاعتك في الدنيا وفي الآخرة في جنات النعيم وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.